Hey guys, welcome back to our channel. If you visited Apple stores, you may found most devices are connected to an anti-theft cable. Today we got this special cable. It looks like an ordinary USB-C cable, but it's actually an anti-theft cable. The length is about 2 meters, and the diameter is 3.08 millimeter. Surprisingly, both USB-C connectors adopt a full pin design, and our Chujula Power ZKM002C shows it's not equipped with an eMarker chip, which means the charging power won't exceed 60 watts. If we look closer at the junction, we found the junction is much wider than ordinary cable, because it has an additional anti-theft cable next to the charging cable. It was cut off before we got it, so we took another cable, for example. This end is pretty like the Ethernet cable connector, which is connected to the table in the retail store. And the other end is attached to the device with a 3M sticker, such as iPhone, iPad, Mac, etc. Once disconnected, the alarm system can be triggered directly. As for charging performance, we use it to charge several devices. The maximum current is limited to 3A, so even if the voltage can reach 20 volts, the power cannot exceed 60 watts. Since the writing and reading speed is only about 35 megabytes per second, which is USB 2.0, so it's only used for charging and anti-theft, not video transmission. Next, let's do a voltage drop test to check the voltage difference between the input and output. Here is the result. We found the largest difference is 0.79 volts at 5 volts 3A and 12 volts 3A, and the smallest difference is 0.25 volts at 9 volts 1A and 20 volts 1A. The differences of 3A is between 0.76 to 0.79 volts, and the differences of 1A is between 0.25 volts to 0.27 volts. The higher the current, the higher the voltage difference. Well, that's the brief introduction to this cable. This is not the only Apple anti-theft cable. For example, the iPhone is a USB-C to Lightning anti-theft cable. The MagSafe wireless charging will be another anti-theft cable. Some high-power devices, like the 16-inch MacBook Pro, need a 140 watts cable. We just want to show you this special cable you may or may not have noticed. Okay, that's all for today's video. You can leave your comments down below if you want to see what the structure looks like inside. And please drop a like, subscribe to us if you like this video. See you in the next video. Bye!